What up, it's your boy Bass, and y'all tuned in to another episode of Ian's Podcast. Today, man, we gonna take it all the way to the West Coast, man, and to one of the old school greats. And no, we not talking about Snoop Dogg, but he out there on the same level. You might not be too familiar, I don't know, depending on how old you is. If you 18 or younger, you probably hip, cause he been on a few G-Eazy songs and stuff like that. He's still relevant to this day doing music, and I'm talking about E-40. You know, shout out to the Bay going dumb, dumb, dumb. You know, being from Detroit, man, the Bay and the D got that. We just got a West Coast connection, and we always just been well connected with each other when it comes down to even the sound, music, and just how we, you know, how we turn up. You feel me? If y'all see in the old previous episode, we was talking about, you know, the car culture. We both into the, you know, burnout. But it's we got Sunday Fun Day, and they got they, you know, they got their same thing. We know they, we turn up in the streets, man. We do little donuts, you feel me, in our muscle cars. They got their same type of cars, and this goes on the D, that goes on in the Bay. But that's neither here nor there. We're gonna be talking about entrepreneurship. We're gonna be talking about hip hop, man. We're gonna be talking about legend, and we're gonna be talking about basically taking and investing. For me, the art of hustle, you know, taking that flip and being able to flip. Basically, you know, just one talent to another talent, man. And starting out, like, we just gonna be talking about E-40, man. And if you're not familiar with E-40, man, E-40 been in the game for a while. And when I say while, I mean a while. He's been in the game for about 30 years. You know, E-40, he from the Bay, you know, coming out from the Bay. And basically, when he first came into the game, man, he came into the game real early on. When he came into the game, that was during the time where, you feel me, you had West Coast, the East Coast, right, be going on, and that's when that West Coast music really started to bump. But then being able to stay relevant, he been able to stay relevant, man. It's just like we said, like for 30 years, I think like he like 50 or 52 or something like that. But he ended up starting like his first entrepreneur grind. Well, you know, he been an entrepreneur before then, but we ain't gonna talk about that. But we talking about his first entrepreneur grind was being the founder of Sick Wit Records. You feel me? Which he still is the founder of today. And Sick Wit Records, if y'all not really too much familiar with it, they got Nefta, Pharoah, OMB, Peezy, and you feel me, Be Legit. Just a few artists, just to, you know, just name drop and throw out there that's, you know, that's making a you know, a lot of noise right now. You feel me, just in the whole music industry right now. And the crazy thing about it was Sick Wit It was founded back in 1989. You feel me? Like 1989. That's why I really want to shed some light on E-40. Like, damn, you started your label back in 1989, and you was able to keep it progressing and keep it relevant still to this time, to where he's in a position to put on other artists from this area and from around the country. You feel me? And as a black man, I feel like, you know, that deserves a round of applause, especially when we want to talk about, you know, entrepreneurship, you feel me, making the most out of your current circumstance and just the art of hustle, being able to flip, you feel me, one talent into another talent, and just, you feel me, being able to utilize that to, you know, to prepare yourself in this world, to prepare, to propel, I gotta say it proper, to propel yourself in this world, you feel me, long story short, but just going, just, you know, just back into, just going back into, you know, E-40, man. You know, I don't know if y'all remember that song, Tell Me When To Go. Tell me when to go, go dum 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 da dum 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 da dum. Ooh, Jesus Christ had dreads. The shake. I ain't got none, but I plan on growing some. You know, that was a very, very, very catchy line that your older brother, uncle, and all of them was probably rapping, you feel me, when they was, you know, like, you know, they was probably rapping. You probably heard them saying that before. You probably familiar with it. And that was around, and that came out around like 2006. Now, he been out since, you feel me, early 90s, since the 90s, you feel me, and he been doing this thing. And with that song in particular, you feel me, that was one of, that brung him back to life back then, you feel me, and that was a mainstream hit that he had with Lil Jon. And you feel me? Just other than that, like, he didn't have it like a legit. I mean, he done had a good career, you feel me? Like, it's as far as a rapper, especially when the time he came out in. But the one thing I always liked about him was being versatile, you know, just being able to stay relevant throughout this whole time, and him playing a large role in, you know, just in the up and coming G-Eazy, and really giving him that blessing too, you feel me, coming out the West Coast. And then G-Eazy ended up turning it, you know, just turning it to being a good sound for, you know, representing that whole Bay Area. But going back into the actual business moves, like the actual business moves that he was making, you feel me, just he opened up, like, you know, a franchise, you know, Fat Burger and things like that before, but now he got the Wingstop. Everybody familiar with Wingstop, you know, after Rick Ross said, "Lemon pepper my wings." come check this out. You feel me? Rick Ross ain't the only one that's invested into Wingstop. You feel me? E-40 is also investing to Wingstop, adding that underneath his portfolio. And then, I don't know if you was, man, I don't know how long y'all been following Ian's podcast. This may be your first episode, or this may be your second, or you might be, you know, a proud supporter. But long story short, we did an episode about Chameleonaire and some of the business moves he did, how he took, you feel me, his rap music and went invested into tech, and then he went from tech to being a venture capitalist, and basically a philanthropist too, you know, invested into women of color startups. But somebody that was partnered along with him was also E-40. You feel me? E-40 being older in the game, I feel like E-40 also got some knowledge and got some experience that he brings to that, you know, to that relationship that they got. You feel me? Between, you know, two black men that's trying to make it, he's trying to invest. So I feel like that's pretty dope that they was able to team up, and they've been building and been investing with each other. You feel me? So E-40 collaborated with him on that actual project, investing into startups from women of color, and then along with another investment group. Well, long story short, you feel me, I would say long story short, but he ended up dropping, you feel me, as his name is E-40, he ended up dropping, you know, a drink called the 40 water, which he talk about a lot. We always talk about branding too, you feel me, like, we always incorporate a lot of tips and, you know, money. We talk about a lot on this podcast. Branding is one thing I love. I like the way he always branded himself. If you know about his music, like, his lingo was always different. What he talked about was different, but it was always consistent, though. You're going to always get the same thing from E-40. Even though his look may evolve, but he always had that E-40 look. And you feel me? And it was perfect that he ended up dropping the 40 water. So, you know, you got E-40. You know, now he venturing off to starting his own products. But then he's also, when we start talking about drinks and just being part of that whole that whole industry, he's also really tapped into the wine industry with Earl Stevens. You feel me? Earl Stevens is really a wine brand using his own name. And it's kind of funny because you know, we drink, like us as a culture, you know, we might drink a lot of wine, but you don't really hear too much about African Americans in general that's really getting into the wine industry. We hear a lot of rappers that get into basically, like, you know, liquor and stuff like that, which he's also tapped into as well. That's also underneath his portfolio. But I just want to say, like, I feel like it was, like, kind of dope to say, like, you feel me, E-40, damn, like, you tapped in with, like, Moscato? Like, you feel me? Like, that's pretty dope. You feel me? A black man or just somebody just in general that just come from the culture that just tapped in with Moscato and just wine in general. And I understand the whole process, and basically it's like a wine connoisseur. You feel me? That can really educate somebody on the process on how to start a wine business and how to actually grow and produce wine, you know, and conduct a winery. You feel me? That's pretty dope. Especially, you know, coming from where we come from, where we just go to the liquor store to go buy wine. We don't really understand the actual process. And if we can actually sit in that seat and own something like that, so him being a representation of one of us sitting in that seat and owning something like that, and being able to, you feel me, basically show that and showcase that to the world and stand on it, it's beautiful. You feel me? In a sense, So yeah. And then, you feel me, just going back into that whole drink, you feel me? He got his own pre-mixed cocktail beverage called the Slurricane Hurricane. Which is pretty dope, because y'all know how he get down with his whole lingo. So what we was saying, you know, he tapped into that whole alcohol, what they call it, the whole spirit industry. You feel me? So, you know, he go after what he know. You know, he out in L.A., he always talking about, you know, being turned up, going hyphy. That's the lingo out there, going dumb, you know, and they be off the juice and all that type of stuff. But you got to think about the juice, you feel me? And think about on top of that, you know, being from the West Coast, you feel me? Everything that they used to always put in them videos, they movies, it was like they kind of branded that like back in the day drinking on what, the 40s, right? You feel me? You be drinking on the 24 ounce or the 40 ounce, but it was a 40, and you know, they call them E-40, and it you know, it goes best served that he released a beer line, you feel me, literally called E-40, which go perfect, you know, 40 ounce, you got a 40, you know, you got that E-40 in your hand. But it just thinking like that though, you feel me? So he being tapped in, like going from wine and cocktails, and then he also got beer, and then also being like a brand ambassador and like spokesman for also a spirit company or liquor company, whatever you want to call it. But you know, well, the term that they call it is spirit, but a lot of us know it as liquor companies. But basically, long story short, being able to brand ambassador and represent a liquor company, but also have its own energy drinks, which if you drink, you understand energy drink and liquor go hand in hand sometimes, especially when you turning up or you just having a long night, or if you just, you know, you need the extra boost. So being able to supply with that energy drink, you know, that 40 water, but also like what I was saying, being tapped in and venturing on the other side, what we also not so accustomed to, but we are accustomed to, because a lot of, like, everybody across the world drink wine, but not too many individuals are invested or understand the process that goes into you know, the wine business or just create wine in general. So him stepping outside the box, being a brother from the hood, you really being, you know, tapping in and, you know, to, you know, to what he do every day. Like, you know, he probably sip wine and, you know, eat good at a restaurant, and you probably be like, damn man, that's a good bottle of wine. I'm, you know, they making, and you think about it too, they make good money off of wine. So yeah, I feel like, you know, that's pretty smart and understanding how to get into that. You know, he can pass that knowledge down. And then, but, you know, and then, you know, number three, too, was also branding, too, man. Like, just, man, going back into the branding, man. Like, I don't think not too many individuals know how big branding is. And for him, and understanding basically how he always used himself and basically the culture he built around himself, like people understanding what type of person or persona, you feel me, that comes with E-40, but him being able to utilize that to venture off and, you know, on the entrepreneurship ground, far as like what I was saying, like, you know, back then, you know, you see motherfuckers always talking about drinking, turning up in the club, but being on the West Coast, you know, 40s, you know, like the 40 ounce beers and stuff like that was, you know, like just known, like they was known for that, you feel me, old English and all that type of stuff, you feel me? So for him to like tap into that, he get his own drink, and you know, but you know, going off the whole drinking tip, just even him being an investor, him tapping in with and basically building that bond with Chameleon there, and them going around and basically investing and flipping their money on that investor tip, but also I think it's like bigger than just the investment. It's him being able to partner up with another brother, you feel me, and just put like, you feel me, they would say, it's why is it so much harder for us to work with our own and stuff like that, but him being able to put the differences to the side and like basically like, man, let's make this money. And then on top of that, they not just making money, but they also investing into their own culture, and they also investing into their own. So you know, I just think that that is a big ass bonus, and I feel like he also need to be, you know, like a round of applause for that though. Like, you feel me? That should be publicized a little bit more. We don't really talk too much, you don't really hear too much in media, individuals talk too much about, you know, the success a lot of these artists are having, other than on the charts, you feel me, and things like that. Like, what about, you know, in business and as men? I feel like these are some success, especially when you start talking about rappers. Being able to take your rap money and put yourself in a position where you can invest into your community, but then you can also invest into the things that you do on an everyday basis, you know, food, you know, how you enjoy your time, but then also taking that and being able to build something, you feel me, with somebody else, you feel me, your brother, you feel me, just build something, you feel me, and being able to reinvest into the community. Ain't nothing more special than that, you feel me? So shout out to E-40, I fuck with you. Fuck with the Bay. I ain't tried the 40 water yet, man. I ain't tried the E-40 yet, man. And you know, I ain't tried the Earl Stevens or nothing like that yet. But if you ever get a hold of this podcast episode E-40, you know, tap in with me. I'd love to come try it out and review it. Fuck it, I might just go make that investment on my own. You feel me? Shout out to E-40. You feel me? Go make that investment. So, you feel me? This is your boy Baz. I almost got lost words for a minute. This is your boy Baz, and y'all tapped in to Ian's podcast, where we always talking about making the most of our current circumstance, because we always trying to eat, and you know, we start out the ground level when you eating in the streets, my baby. Hey man, but we also gonna say, man, if you want to help support us, man, and you want to do it for free, you can go ahead, like, share, subscribe. And if you really like and support what we really doing, and you want to, you know, help us reach that next level, we got a few ways that you can do that, man. You can support by, you know, popping the ends merchandise, or you can also support by becoming a patron, which come with cool features like being able to be featured on a podcast episode. We receive free monthly merchandise, you know, free sponsorship, monthly sponsorship on podcast episode, shout outs, you know, all type of things, man, that we'll be able to basically, you know, offer you for, you know, for your generosity. And even if not, you know, we're gonna still be doing giveaways and stuff like that for those that stay tapped in, like we said, even on the free side. So we appreciate all y'all and all y'all supports, because I've been seeing the numbers been going crazy lately. So I appreciate all y'all support, man. And man, we just ready to have more voices and just trying to get more voices out here, man, because we understand the power of the voice, and that's what we're here to do, man, because we're the voice of the culture. It's your boy Baz, it's Ian's podcast, and we out.